I recently got a special delivery from a subscriber. They've said they built something unique and that's going to make my NeoVim and terminal experience 10 times better. After over a decade of going through very special keyboards, I thought I've seen everything, but still I was intrigued. I expected to see a monster in the box, but it was a pretty simple, super light and lean board shaped like Batman. And two sheets of paper explaining the layout. Looking at this got me thinking. And to make a long story short, it didn't get me to change my beloved daily driver, which can do things you didn't even know are possible, and I'll cover all of them in just a bit. But what it did do is make me learn a few fundamental concepts, throwing me into yet another rabbit hole. So shout out to Leo for building this cute thing and sending it over. Now let's talk about my keyboard system and how I configured it to be the perfect typing tool and the ultimate coding companion. A quick post-production clarification. I wasn't paid by any of the brands you'll see in this video. I got one board as a gift with nothing in return, and the rest were bought with my own money. The only one brand that is aware of this video before coming out is actually the one that doesn't sponsor or collaborate as a policy. And the reason they're aware is because I asked them for their personal comment, which I bring later in the video. Alright, with that out of the way. This is the Moonlander, a split keyboard with all the split keyboard usuals. A thumb cluster, background LED lights, tinting options, and more. But this isn't even a fraction of what the Moonlander can do, and I want to share not only the in-your-face features, but the ideas and background that led me to where I am now. I'm not a fast typist, but I can conveniently type around 100 words per minute on the Moonlander as it is, and we'll get to that later. But let's rewind a little bit. Remember the Batman keyboard? This is the ADM, and this is the sheet of paper it comes with, holding the layout and the rationale behind it. Like I said, it's not something I use daily, but it's a cool little toy with some interesting concepts behind that inspired me to make some fundamental changes. Starting off, this board is slim, there's no numbers row, and the keys only go as far as your fingertips can go without moving the palm of your hand. Remember this concept for later, because orientation with keyboards, especially if you're aiming to type blindly, is key. The thumb cluster is a weird animal here. The return key is in the middle, serving both hands. The escape is the first in line in the thumb cluster, thinking about modal editor users like NeoVim who use escape a lot. Instead of extending your finger, escape comes closer. I personally use JJ for years now, and for the same reason, this isn't a game changer for my specific use case. Similar to the Moonlander, the Advantage 360 and other split keyboards, backspace and space are the two main thumb cluster keys, which on the ADM, they come next. Typing on this thing is a special experience, both because it's a slim layout, but also because of how the rows are aligned based on fingers length rather than physical symmetry. This is kind of genius if you think about it, and it's not easy to get used to, but when I let my mind stop thinking for a moment and let my fingers move naturally, I was a bit shocked in how they naturally fell into place and went through words with relative ease. For a layout that's completely different from both normal keyboards and what I use daily, this is quite impressive. I certainly didn't come close to this when I first got my Moonlander. Let me pop Batman back to the nice magnetic USB cable it comes with so I could tell you where it all started for me. About 8 years ago, my mentor at the time was using a weird keyboard. Not visually appealing, it had blank keycaps, and it used the cable. When he told me it costs over $300, I didn't know if I should laugh or report him to the authorities. Long story short, it took me exactly 1 month to order my own HHKB, and let me tell you something, to this day, it's hands down the best typing experience I've ever had. The HHKB comes with Topra, a rubber dome that collapses into itself with every keystroke, creating the most satisfying typing you can imagine. What you hear now is the board after lubing the sliders, because the HHKB doesn't have switches per se like normal keyboards for the mechanical keyboards fans here, but it can be lubed. The sound and feel of these switches is something I wish I had on a split keyboard, and the day these people make a split keyboard, you have my word, I'm the first in line. There's nothing special other than that about it. It doesn't come with a new layout, the rows and columns aren't linear, just like your typical laptop keyboard. It does, however, show character by ditching the arrow keys altogether and ingraining the logo instead. Having the arrow keys stacked on one corner is the mother of all bad typing habits, and I had to learn this the hard way. Before presenting the main character, I'd also like to mention my Nuphy Air 60, claiming to be the thinnest mechanical keyboard in the world, with Bluetooth and wired connections, multiple device management, a cute look, and a very nice typing experience. It also comes with rubber hinges that line up perfectly on a Mac keyboard, so it can literally sit on top of it without taking any other space. If I'm traveling and packing light, the Nuphy comes next to my laptop. It won't be as fast, but it's definitely better as far as typing experience go than the Mac keyboard for extended periods of time. Okay, ladies and gents, the Moonlander, a split keyboard. The only way you can type and drink your coffee with style. And if you're serious about coffee like I am, getting a split keyboard should be a no-brainer. Jokes aside though, the first and obvious features of a split keyboard is its ergonomics. It's not for nothing that the first product ZSA, the company behind the Moonlander, was named the ErgoDox. Its monthly newsletter, which is one of the best ones on the internet, and here's a free tip, is called the Ergo. Typing on two parts allows for natural positioning of your hands, affecting the chest and shoulders, and this goes as far as breathing. Try this one out now. Take a deep breath with your keyboard, then move your hands to the sides, open your chest, and a deep breath. Feel the difference? This goes beyond just convenience. You can think, type, and work with these for longer periods of time. Especially those who suffer from repetitive strain injuries can find comfort in a natural hand position. This isn't the only angle the ergonomics can change with the Moonlander, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. The key layout is columnal and not staggered like other typical boards, and this also helps with finger ergonomics, where it strives to follow the physical pattern of the body rather than a typing machine that was actually only designed this way to prevent the ink levers from hitting each other on the way. One pillar that Erez, the founder of ZSA, talks about a lot is mobility. Using two free parts allow for a lot of movement too. You can rotate them individually, in and out, and play with it during the day. The boards were designed for this and are meant to not be anchored to one spot. Understanding that we all have slightly different geometry and preferences, split keyboards come with ways to configure keys. ZSA took this to a whole new level. Not only it comes with a visual UI where you don't have to compile C code and download it to your board, it goes way deeper into every single key, its modes and its LED colors. Oryx, the software that it comes with, can pretty much change everything you can think of with features you never knew you wanted. Starting off with a thumb cluster and keys. Do note that what you're seeing here is my personal setup after a lot of tweaking and configuration and 2 years of changes, so the positions here are not set in stone. My super and alt keys, command and options for macOS users, are at my thumb, but not my thumb cluster. I also flipped the keycaps on them to make them accessible to my thumb rather than the index finger, which they were probably intended for. I did the same thing with the first key on the right hand, used as control if held down. And this brings us to the power of Oryx. Each individual key can do lots of things. It can yield one signal when tapped, like a backslash in this instance, but it can also be configured to do something else when held, or when double tapped, or when double tapped and then held, each with different signal coming from the same key. Now let's talk again about layers. This is something I took from the ADM. My useful symbols are right there at my left palm, but the killer feature, in my opinion, is the numpad on the other hand. Who needs a numbers row when you can type numbers blindly? You may be asking yourself why I'm keeping the top row still, and that's a great question. As soon as I'm ready with a symbol, these switches are going to be taken off. The Moonlander layers don't end there. By default, it comes with a second layer that I'm rarely using at this point, but it does hold different combos and even a mouse mode, which I can use my keys to move the cursor with and even click around. Remember my combos? Here are some examples I configured with Oryx. Viewing the Tmux history, usually done with prefix plus square brackets, was way too annoying. I could have configured it differently, but Oryx lets you just pick a bunch of keys that, when grouped into a keystroke, perform the key combo configured. In this instance, I picked the three keys at the tips of my right hand palm to do it for me. Let's take another look at how you can leverage different keystrokes with one key. My left thumb cluster key, usually used as backspace, also doubles as shift when held. Another takeaway from the ADM that's quite literally changed how I type, and you may have noticed I removed the shift keys altogether. What it also does is delete an entire word when double tapped, which is a tip I got from actually an Ali Abdal video of all people. Instead of endlessly typing backspace when making a mistake, getting used to deleting the entire word isn't only quicker, but also forces you to practice writing the word again. Well, what's better than getting used to command backspace? You're right, getting used to double tapping backspace for the same effect. Another great aspect of the Moonlander is that it's a standard mechanical keyboard, where you can pop keycaps and the switches under them and change them when you feel like it. These are the Gatorade yellows, and it comes pre-lubed, which I've switched to tactile silent ones at the end of the video just to switch things up. No pun intended. One of the best mods I made with the Moonlander is tenting it, and while it comes with its own little legs that you can fold and adjust, recently, following a recommendation of Josh Medeski, and check out his channel in the description, I got the platform from ZSA. Make no mistake, this is not a cheap product, and ZSA does provide a bunch of open source alternatives that you can 3D print, but I went all out with this one and I absolutely love it. The platform attaches to the Moonlander with 4 screws, and they can be adjusted with a simple Allen key. You can go full on ridiculous mode, which I somehow made work in a not completely embarrassing way, but my usual setup is somewhere around the 45 degrees level. It comes with marked dots to help you go back to your previous location and making sure both sides are aligned with each other. This thing also tends to slide on my table because it's just an aluminum plate, so I super glued a bunch of rubber feet underneath because they kept getting smashed and removed with the force of typing. With proper positioning and angles, this is the ergonomic Moonlander setup and how I type almost all day, every single day. Before giving you a feel of replacing keys on the Moonlander and the new sound it has now, I want to dedicate a minute to talk about Ares, the founder of ZSA that made a deep impression on me and I feel I need to share. I reached out to Ares a few months back suggesting we collaborate on a video. He politely replied saying that ZSA doesn't collaborate or invest in any type of marketing and that their products speak for themselves. Wow, I thought, how did these guys even survive? But after listening to Ares on a recent changelog podcast, which I'll leave a link to below, I had to reach out again. I opened my email with Ares, I get it. I told him how everything he said about collaborations, marketing, and more made sense after listening, and I asked for his open comment to a video I'm making covering my Moonlander, to which he responded in his own very special way. He shared the Why Trust Us document he's working on and hasn't shared yet with the world. So here's the gist of it. A ZSA keyboard is an investment. If you're trying to figure out which reviews you can trust, know this. ZSA doesn't pay influencers, or reviewers, or any sort of coverage, period. The keyboards are priced fairly year-round. ZSA doesn't have an affiliate program or resellers, they don't sell their products on Amazon or any other platform other than their own. They believe in solid products that last, they don't care about margins and scale, they care about customer satisfaction, and using their hard-earned reputation, their marketing machine is an honest word of mouth, just like the one I'm delivering here. But I think I'll pause my love letter here and urge you to at least check them out and let me know in the comments below what you've thought. As promised, in my journey to bring my keyboard to a thocky sound, I keep changing my switches, and while the Moonlander was built as a very lean and slim board, a feature that makes the sound flat to begin with, I'm still trying. So I decided to take out all the switches and loop them thoroughly and listen to the end result through the microphone. I can definitely say I'm happy with it, but this is where you come in. Let me know in the comments what you've thought. So without further ado, here's the untouched recording from the lubed Gatron Yellows. Having a properly configured keyboard is key, but without a proper writing setup, you just move the bottleneck elsewhere. So in this next video, I'm going to show you how to set up your NeoVim to make the perfect writing environment, even if you're not writing code. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.